I'm just gonna wait in the background watching you talk to her. I know this might look bad, but I'm just gonna melt in the background watching you lean into her.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Caitlin Bongers and I'm a Dutch illustrator and ceramist, and I'm also a YouTuber, kind of. I know it's been a little while, it's been almost a month since I've posted a YouTube video, and I've thought about making YouTube videos, and I have a lot of ideas of what I want to make and where I want to go with my channel, but it's just been so busy. Now I'm not on a YouTube schedule anymore, and I just have to find time to make videos. It's been really hard, and time is flying so fast. And that's also been that I just haven't found any time to draw. If you guys know me and know my work a little bit, then you probably know that I earn most of my money of my ceramists. I make a ceramist watercolor palettes like the one you see me using in this video here right now, and I have to put this much time in it because I need to make money to live off, of course. If I don't do this, then I have to search for a job. Well, this is a job, but for a different job. And I might actually still have to do that because I'm not earning quite enough yet. But yeah, my illustration, my drawings are not making me a lot of money at the moment. And that's why I put a lot of effort in ceramics. And I have asked myself the question, should I just put all my efforts in ceramics? Should I just become a ceramic artist and just draw for fun? Or should I still try to get further in my illustration career? And I know a lot of you guys are probably struggling with this question. Should I continue doing illustration, or should I just give up? And I have put a lot of thought in this in the last couple of weeks, and I have thought about what are the reasons for me to draw and why I want to continue drawing. And I hope they will be of some help to you. And yeah. So, a little bit of a backstory. In 2018, I decided that I wanted to be an artist. I was 20 years old and I had thought about being an artist for my whole life, but I never took it seriously. And from this point on, I said, I'm going to be an artist. I'm gonna put my full effort into drawing, into getting better, and I'm gonna make it. And at first, the reason to do this was just that I really wanted to do something fun for my job. At the time, I was studying data science. I was learning how to program, and I saw myself sitting behind the desk looking at lists of data all day long. And I was not enjoying it, so I switched to art school, and I just wanted to try and really do something fun before I would give up on it and try to do something else. And now I'm doing ceramics, which is also a lot of fun, and I can actually almost make a living of it. So what I thought is, I don't really need drawing anymore. I can do it as a relaxation, but I'm pretty sure I can make ceramics into my job, so why do I still want to keep drawing? And even though I really like ceramics, and it's a really rewarding process to get your own ceramic pieces back out of the kiln, I found that ceramics isn't what I want to give to the world. I think that if my entire career is just only making stuff and selling stuff, it wouldn't really be fulfilling to me. For me, I feel like I want to be helping people in a certain way. And well, I do believe that the pieces of ceramics I make, mostly make ceramic art supplies, I do believe that these will help people have a more enjoyable time creating, but it's not in the same way that I feel like I can help people with my YouTube videos or with my art or with a comic I would write. When I look around me in the world and I see things that are frustrating me, things where people feel discriminated, racism, sexism, things where the climate is going in the wrong direction, I feel so incredibly helpless. I'm not sure what I can do more to fight against these things, and I feel like in my art I can still make a difference. I want to believe that if I make a comic and if I talk about body positivity and accepting yourself, and I show a character that has to grow towards a better path, I feel like I can help young children who will read my comic make those choices easier for themselves. And that's really something that I value and that I still want to do. So yeah, this has become a kind of rambly video, and I want to kind of put it all together in a more logical way. So one, of course, drawing for me is fun, something that I can't give up because it's just very relaxing for me to do and I enjoy doing it a lot. But two, I think it's something that I can still achieve a lot of my goals with. And my goals are to help people live better lives, help people accept themselves, and hopefully in that way also help them being a better person, caring for the environment, caring for others around them. And that's a really big goal, but I feel like I can do that a little bit if I make my art in a certain way. And I have a lot of people here on my YouTube channel that tell me that my videos are helping them in a way to get motivated or to get creating again, or just to relax and have their minds off all the busy things in life. And that just makes me feel great and makes me want to keep doing this for a very long time. And I want to note that the thing I never mentioned in this video, I don't want to think about whether I am good enough to be an illustrator, because I don't think that not being good enough is a reason to quit. I have so many years in front of me where I can still be drawing and still be improving. If it has to take me 40 years to make my dreams come true, then that's totally okay for me. So not being good enough is not a reason for me to quit. There's only one reason for me to ever quit drawing, and that reason is if I'm entirely not enjoying it anymore. Okay, so that's about what I wanted to say about this topic. This video is very short, and I could probably talk like 40-50 minutes, maybe even more than that about this topic, but I hope it still was kind of useful to you. Let me know in the comments what helps you to keep drawing, what is your motivation, and why do you feel the need to keep doing it. Maybe thinking about this and writing it down will help you if you're struggling with the question whether you should give up or not. And if the answer to that question for you is just because you enjoy it, then remember, that's totally fine too. You don't need to have a deep specific reason to keep drawing. And that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!